You've got fuel, compression, and bright blue spark. So why won't your engine run? Well, what if I told you the problem wasn't if you had spark, but when you have it? Testing ignition timing is an essential diagnostic procedure that any mechanic should know how to do. Therefore, in today's short video, I'll show you that exact process, and I think you'll be surprised at just how easy and quick it is to do. It takes just a couple of minutes, and in return, it saves you hours of tail chasing and expensive and unnecessary repair bills too. In fact, I consider a timing light, which is a very affordable tool, and of course, what we need to do this test, to be one of the most underrated in a mechanic's toolbox. Yet I haven't seen any other small engine mechanic on YouTube talk about it or show how to use one. You see, most people assume that if the engine has bright blue spark, that the ignition coil is not their issue, and they move on to the next step in their diagnostic procedure. Yet of course, without that spark firing at just the right time, your engine's never going to run, regardless of how strong the spark is. And there are many reasons why your timing can be incorrect, and therefore it's something we'll cover later in today's video. As mentioned, to do this test, we need a timing light. And I've put links in the description below to the one that I recommend. Being self-powered, it offers the freedom to test ignition timing on any engine, including those that don't have a battery source. So the first step in the process is to turn the ignition switch on. The next step is to take into account which way the engine turns when it's running, and you can simply pull the pull cord and watch that fan on the flywheel rotate and note it down. And in this case for my machine, it's anti-clockwise. Next, we remove the recoil completely and the spark plug as well, and securely ground that spark plug onto the metal housing somewhere on or around that engine. Now slowly rotate that flywheel until the piston reaches the top of the cylinder, which we refer to as top dead center. And on engines that are harder to reach or see, you can place a pencil in the spark plug hole, turn the engine over, and when the pencil stops rising, you know you're at top dead center. Next, we make two marks, ideally with something like a bright paint pen, one on the outer circumference of the flywheel, and the second mark adjacent to it on the housing itself. From here, we need to make another mark 30 degrees in the opposite direction to the engine's rotation, and this is known as before top dead center. Although you can use a degree wheel here, I recommend you simply estimate it. Close enough is good enough for this simple test. I find the easiest way is to see the flywheel as a clock face, and either the 1 o'clock or the 11 o'clock is your 30 degree position, depending on the engine's rotation. Remember, it's got to be marked in the opposite direction to the engine's rotation. So if it's going anti-clockwise, we must mark 30 degrees in the clockwise direction at, say, 1 o'clock. And this 30 degree span is what I'll refer to as our ignition timing window. Now we connect our ignition pickup from the timing light onto our spark plug lead, ensuring that the arrow on the pickup points towards the spark plug. To generate the voltage we need for the ignition system to work, we'll spin the engine over using a drill, but I recommend that you have a ratcheting adapter between the drill and that socket. If you happen to stop that drill abruptly, the momentum of the engine will carry on spinning the ratchet rather than spinning the drill and your wrist holding onto it. So we start to rotate that flywheel in the direction that the engine runs, and we depress the timing light button and hold it over the two external marks of our ignition window. Every time the ignition fires, the timing light will flash and the mark we placed on the flywheel should appear within that 30 degrees. On older engines that don't have ignition advance, the flywheel mark will show somewhere around 26 degrees. On more modern engines with ignition advance built into the coil, we expect that flywheel mark to appear closer to the 5 degrees with the speed that we can achieve with the drill. Ultimately, so long as the flywheel mark appears within this window, ignition timing isn't the reason your engine isn't running. Now, I know this chainsaw actually runs well, so we'll do something slightly different and we'll time it with the engine running. This way I can demonstrate how the timing mark moved closer to 30 degrees as I increase the engine's RPM due to the advanced ignition curve built into the coil. You see, as the piston speed increases as we accelerate, the flame front doesn't speed up linearly. So by igniting the fuel charge earlier with ignition advance, as the engine RPM increases, it allows time for the flame front to propagate and its peak pressure acting on the piston is still applied at the ideal time. This is when the crank and that connecting rod geometry give us the most leverage to turn that pressure into torque, and that's somewhere around 15 degrees after top dead center. If it's too early, it fights the piston and it can cause kickback. That's when the pull rope gets yanked out of your hand. Too late, and that combustion pressure is lost, resulting in a weak engine. It's also worth noting that if your engine starts and idles well, but it can't reach above or it fails above a set RPM, you can repeat this exact same process and see what's happening with your timing mark. If it stays within your ignition window at that point and it's consistent, you've ruled out timing as being your issue. And there are many reasons why your timing may be incorrect, from a sheared flywheel key, a loose or misadjusted stator, a failure of the microprocessor inside the CDI, a fouled plug, worn points, failing condenser, an incorrectly positioned ignition coil, or even a fault during the production at the factory. And on the topic of poorly running engines, carburetors are one of the most common reasons our engines don't run right. And I go into great detail on how to diagnose and repair this issue in a video up here for you next.